DaVinci has every required thing inside the program in different tabs. It's everything everywhere all at once. Whereas Adobe have different programs and it's not a fair comparison. If you need a free program, DaVinci Resolve is the obvious winner here. But if you are going to pay, Premiere might have its own advantages. Hear me out. So what's the deal with people changing apps? Is one of them better? I don't think so. They're just different and I use both. But if you want to choose one, you have three options. DaVinci Resolve free. If it's enough for you, there's no question. You can close the video now. DaVinci Resolve Studio and Adobe Creative Cloud Monthly. I don't think anyone signs up for only specifically Premiere. Because that's why I'm going to think if you get Adobe, you'll get the whole package. And comparing a nonlinear video editor with amazing color grading, sound editing, mixing, visual effects capabilities, with a creative suite that includes lots of different programs like Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, XD, Animation Something, Substance, as well as Premiere, Audition, After Effects, is not fair. And here is the five things I like about DaVinci Resolve, and also I'm gonna give my idea on why not to switch to DaVinci Resolve. Definitely color grading, masking, tracking, and all these effects are great in DaVinci Resolve. Also, I feel like color management is better, color spaces, etc. Free version is enough for most people, but for the real performance and neural engine effects like smart masking, auto depth map, the new AI voice isolation, I haven't tried it yet, but I feel it's a great thing, noise reduction, and some other great open effects, you need to subscribe to the studio version. So it is paid. With DaVinci Resolve, the same program works on iPad too. That's crazy. You can use free version to edit and come home and use your studio or free version on your PC or Mac. It's very handy. I'm going to try editing my next video on my iPad and continue on Mac. If you want to know when I release that video, turn on your bells so know when I release it. Thank you. DaVinci has every required thing inside the program in different tabs. It's everything everywhere all at once. Whereas Adobe have different programs and it connects them via something called dynamic link, which is not perfect. For video and sound editing, Resolve is fine. But if you have been using After Effects like me, if you are used to layer-based compositions, working with layers, I feel like Adobe After Effects is good and quite powerful. I couldn't spend time learning Fusion. When I need, I just turn on After Effects' familiar interface and do whatever I want. But of course, I know that the node-based visual effects workflow is superior, but it's a personal choice. DaVinci Resolve has scaling issues and UI issues. You can't arrange the UI and the second screen as you wish, which brings Premiere's pros. Premiere and all Adobe programs definitely have better dual screen and scaling things. You can move any window anywhere. Same for After Effects and Photoshop and goes on. Premiere had better audio noise reduction, but now with the 18, DaVinci also has the AI noise remover with the studio version. If you're making basic color correction, Lumetri is fine. Also, hue-based curve adjustments, etc. are okay, but I believe it lacks masking and tracking. I know you can sort of do it, but it's definitely not designed for it, like not like DaVinci Resolve. Adobe has great image editing tools like Photoshop, Lightroom inside the bundle, but if you only use these for thumbnail creation, you can find free online tools as well. All Adobe products have better and more templates, motion graphic templates, transition packs, etc. if you use them. Last but not least, auto subtitle generation. I use it a lot for YouTube, but it's a nice thing to have. But you can find free online tools as well, so it's not a necessary thing right now. Yeah, if you have any other thoughts, please let me know in the comment section below. I believe if you're editing short films, commercials, etc., any program should work. Even DaVinci Resolve free is fine, because you will cut the pieces. But in today's fast Instagram, YouTube Shorts, TikTok world, if you require fancy transitions, effects, or motion graphic templates, Adobe Creative Suite could be a better option for now, but DaVinci is coming, it's catching up. However, you could consider using DaVinci Resolve's free version instead of paying Adobe monthly. With the money you saved, you could subscribe to a stock footage service. For example, I use Envato Elements, it's cheaper and quite extensive, and you can access lots of title animations, transitions, sound, music, etc. to improve the overall quality of your videos. I subscribe to it as a lecturer last year. There's a great student and teacher discount. This is not a sponsored thing, but I'll give you an affiliate link down below. No extra cost to you, but I may get a little share if you decide to subscribe to it. You can check it out. That's it for today. See you in another video. Bye.